Welcome on Palpable TV. You are simplified.
Palpable TV, you are simplified media. You are once again most welcome on the show. Remember, this is direction, and we appreciate much time you offer to watch our TV. And that is why we keep on bringing different views and different guests on our TV. Today, we are going to discuss about girl child education. Simply because most people out up to now, they are not taking serious to educate girls. And remember, one writer said that when you educate a woman, you are educating the nation. When you educate man, you are educating individuals. So we are basing on that ground to discuss that matter. And don't forget that our show is proudly sponsored by Palpable Technologies Limited, and experts in all ICT services. They can build for a website, application, systems, and other related services. So you can get them on WhatsApp number +256 75 238 3767. And on the show, I am not alone. I have my guest who is educated, and she's a woman. She's going to tell you about our matter. And madam, you are most welcome on the show. This is Palpable TV. Greet our viewers, and from there we'll switch on.
Hello, my name is Emily Kentenje, and I am a lawyer. I'm currently working for Foundation for Human Rights Initiative in Zambia, Human Rights House. Thank you,
okay.
Director. Welcome to.
Okay, you are most welcome. Okay, our viewers, the person is our guest today, and the topic today we want to see why and how ladies should be empowered as far as education is concerned, and why should we need so. Because you know, women, they are the mother of the nation, and when we take it light by not taking them, really we will be now not adding development to our country. So madam, since you work with human rights, I hope education is a right. And now I want you to tell us briefly, to some families it is not taken serious vis-a-vis empowering women so that they can upbring other children, as far as informing them on the.
Let me start with why most people have doubts on education. Personally, I know one of my relatives who commented, who discouraged my father to take me to school. And this person went ahead to tell my father that educating a girl child is because of the examples they take from other people. Of which you all know that everyone have their they fall short of the glory. They have their weaknesses. So someone else's weakness shouldn't deny me my right to education. As you all know, it's also a human right for every person to go to school, to be educated. So I think most people doubt that they bias educating a girl because they think along the way a girl is going to drop out and get married, and along the way maybe they think also girls are weak-minded, tempted first. But we see it's both sides. What can draw away a girl from attending school can draw away a boy from attending school. We see it as I've grown up, I've seen a number of students that are chased away from school, that are expelled from schools, are boys. So I don't think discouraging a parent from educating their child is right.
cut you short. Thank you very much for that overview. Without shout. Oh, our viewers, we appreciate always to keep it on Palpable TV, and it's your simplified media. And we don't forget to go out and support Laser Shine Brands. These are leading producers of quality shoe polish, cream, and they have a lot of brands. You can get them Gayaza, Rot, Wakiso, and also you can contact them on +256 70 42 04 893. That's the director's contact. You can reach him for any supply. And now to come back on the matter, Emily, you see, the reason why we are discussing this matter, we want to tell the public the good things that happens when you educate girls. And I want you to take it from there to tell the public. Since you are educated, you are a lawyer, you are working with human rights, I want you to sensitize people out there who and are looking, educating girl child by telling them the good things that happens when you educate a girl child. Take it.
I would like to concur with you on your earlier statement that you said educating a girl is educating a nation. If you are to look around currently in the whole world, it's the women who are taking care of, who are taking up the roles of men in families. So I see it's very important to educate a girl. If they can take up roles of men, why they're not educated? Irrespective of whether they're educated or not educated, if you go to villages, you find most of the people who struggle to raise school fees for their children. You find even in families where the women are educated, where wives are not just housewives, you find it's women that are bringing much money on the table, who are bringing much income in the family at home, are contributing a bigger part of money, maintain the family. So if they can do that, why they are less educated, or some are not even educated? So I think educating a girl child is as more important as educating a boy child. And another thing, it's very good to educate a girl. Reason being, it is good to equip them with knowledge. Why deny them? I believe in equality. We are all equal before God. That's what even the Bible says. God looks at us all as his children. So I don't see why we should discriminate and say that now I'm going to educate girls first. I mean, I'm going to educate boys first, and then girls can come in later on. They should not even go to school. Like, they don't need to go to school. That is very wrong, because God doesn't look at them like that. He gifted us differently, and when you educate us, now you're going to equip me with knowledge of how I'm going to use the gift God gave me. For instance, maybe I have a gift of singing. So if you take me to a music school, you're going to equip me with knowledge of how to use the talent that God gave me. Thirdly, I think educating a girl child is not a sin. I don't see it where it is mentioned in the Bible as a sin. So most ancient people used to think that when educate a girl, they are going to have a bigger voice than men, and which is wrong. It depends on your attitude. So I think people should always change their attitude towards female creatures. They are good people, they are kind, and also men are kind. Whatever can fail a man can also, whatever can fail a girl can also fail a boy, in order to start up a small stall. But in this generation we are in, we have many educated boys, educated males, but you find all they do is they are depending on even illiterate illiterate females, illiterate girls. Why? Because they have knowledge to work and maintain their lives. They have knowledge to raise a family. I think naturally, females are gifted.
Okay, our guest, sorry, I want to cut you short.
Yes.
Yourself, since you are educated,
yes,
living example, how are you enjoying the fact that you are educated? You see, the challenge is, from what you're saying, parents have bias to educate women because of what happens, and that when they pay for you money or they have paid school fees, you reach somewhere, because now the voice I'm speaking, there are things that happen in the community. You spend billions of money to girls, you find that girl after graduating, she goes with a chip. They go and marry without the consent of their parents. And leave alone marriage, it is not enough with marriage. Again, you find that girl who has paid tuition or school fees for, she fails to bring a return at home. Instead, she diverts the return maybe to boyfriends and so on. So it is on that ground that actually also other factors, they are cultural. But of course, in culture, we select the important values and we leave the values that have no purpose. They say that culture, women are supposed to stay at home. They are not supposed to be exposed to the public. Now, after you have filtered that fact that is not enough, how about the other side where I'm talking about that girls, they divert resources. They educated to empower your younger sisters and brothers or even your parents, since they have grown old, they are not able to serve themselves, but they keep on diverting resources to the side of their boyfriends, the family, and so on. How do you have to talk about that?
Okay. First, I think I'm going to address, well, let me talk about how,
in other words, they devalue, women devalue themselves. They devalue. They have empowered you to have value, but you devalue. You find you're going with the cheap boys, with the cheap boyfriends, and so on, which annoys the parents and hence now losing morale of continue paying and sponsor their daughters and so on.
Okay, let me first talk about how I'm enjoying my life since I am educated. Didn't you talk about that?
Yeah, I did.
Yes, the fact that I am educated, I am equipped with knowledge, specifically the law. So I enjoy that so much that I have knowledge of the law, be it human rights, be it civil, be it anything, land rights, whatever, environmental rights. So I love it so much that I am enjoying. No one is taking advantage of me. You know, when you're not, you're so illiterate about something, or you're very green about something, the person who has knowledge about that very thing is going to take advantage of you. So I think as a woman who is educated, I know my rights as a woman. And that helps me so much, that no one is going to take advantage of me. Let's say if I get married in future, I will know all the rights I have as a married woman. But even while I'm still single, I still know my rights. For instance, I don't have to tag myself on a man because they're educated to depend on them. Let's say I have a land issue in my family. I don't have to first go and sleep with an educated lawyer now to get their legal advice or legal services. I know exactly what the law says. I know exactly where to run to. Maybe I can also help my fellow young women, young girls who have given birth while they're not married yet, who have dropped out of school. I know how I can help them to get maintenance for their kids. It helps me. I love it when I am helping a single mother out there who is struggling to raise their kid. And they want support from the father of the kid. And actually you find, in some cases I've met with people, you find that the guy who impregnated her is very educated, knows really what to do, but I don't even want to help. So I feel so happy when I'm helping such a person.
Okay, our guest, because with the interest of time, sorry to cut you short, with the interest of time, I want you to shed more light on, in just 1 minute, on the girls who devalue themselves, having been paid school fees, tuition, in other words, having been empowered through all the channels of empowerment, through education and all that, who devalue themselves by choosing wrong relationships that do annoy parents out there. And from there, we also go to our conclusion remark, where I will request you to advise girls who have no voice. You see, there are girls out there who have passion to go to school, but because of the factors we talked about, they have no voice. You, as a human rights lawyer, I want you to give them an alternative. Those who have passion to go to school and they have no voice, they have nowhere they can run to be accepted to go to school, maybe by their caretakers and so on. And also lastly, you send greetings to your friends, different home, your relatives and so on. So start from there.
Okay, briefly, let me correct you. It is not devaluing themselves. I think if someone chooses what they want in life, what they feel gives them peace, it's not devaluing. If I see that this other person I've chosen, who you say it is, I'm devaluing myself, I've gone with a boyfriend maybe who is broke, maybe I believe in them in future, they're going to be better. Maybe they're also educated, but they're still struggling. In this Uganda, it's very hard to get employment.
These are public views. They are not views of powerful kids. They are public views. People out there speak those things and they are real life. So, please.
Yes, I get to understand. And I'm, for instance, I've seen instances where parents choose marriage partners for their children and they say, so you go and marry in someone's family, but you find after a few years they are even no longer together because they were unhappy in that marriage. But if I choose the person I want, we go ahead and build ourselves. You find in future we are better. I think I have not chosen badly and I have not devalued myself. And another thing, I want to encourage parents, educate your children. I think them bringing something back home is how you raised them yourself. So it is about how you raise someone from their childhood. If you raise them showing that when you go out there you bring something back home, I think also when they go out there and they bring something, or if you grew up showing them love, I think why not bring something back home when they have got it?
Okay, that is very important. It's our pleasure to have you on Palpable TV. And it's your simplified media. Remember, our viewers, go out there and support Laser Shine Brands. This is your trusted shoe cream. They have all categories of polish and laser accessories. So you can find them along Gayaza Road, and also you can contact them on +256 7042 04 893. So our guest, in your conclusion, I want you to advise the voiceless one, especially girls, and there are many. They are always on our Palpable TV or they watch from somewhere, but I want to advise them through your human rights platform and how they should push their dreams of going to school. Just in 1 minute, and lastly, send greetings to your people.
Okay, thank you, Director. I want to encourage parents who have bias on educating a girl child. It is very important. It equips them with knowledge. it will help them in future not to be taken advantage of.
I think it is not parents. Now girls who are placed down, who have willing to go to school, because these things are happening to the public. You find you are ready to go to school, but because your caretakers, caretakers can be parents, can be any other person that is responsible for those individuals, and they have no alternative. What should they do? Should they hang themselves? Should they go to police and report? What should they do legally? If you want to go to school and you don't have access, you are stopped by your caretakers. This is the point I want you to bring clearly.
Okay, maybe
you are not getting. I'm saying girls who want to go to school, they are willing, but the caretakers don't allow them. They are pressed, they have no voice. So you as a legal person, and being that you are near to human rights, how would you advise those children out?
Well, I would advise you, first of all, pray about it, because irrespective of my parents' support and all this stuff, I used to pray for myself. I am a believer. Give your life to God and pray about it. And another thing, engage a third party to speak to your caretaker, to your parent, to any other person that is in your custody, who is in charge of paying your school fees. Maybe you can engage, also come to FHRI, Foundation for Human Rights in Zambia. We can call your parent, we can call your guardian and speak to them, and they understand the value of educating a girl child. It is very important. An educated girl is a very equipped girl, is an armed girl in our generation. It is very important. An illiterate girl is going to face a lot of challenges in future. So thank you for listening to Power TV. My name is Emine Kentenje, and I send my greetings to Executive Director Foundation for Human Rights in Zambia, Human Rights House. I send my greetings to my family, my siblings, my dad. I send my greetings to my church people, New Life Church, Kabalagala, my pastor, Pastor Paddy. I love you so much. Thank you all for listening.
Okay, our guest, it has been a pleasure to host you, and also appreciate you to honor our invitation. Educated girl is equipped one, said by our guest. And our viewers also, thank you very much for keeping it on. We want to wish you a very good evening. Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching Palpable TV.